The government shutdown now entering day three and could possibly extend into the new year.
So as Democrats continue to resist the president's demand to secure the border, our next guest says the president says he should stand firm in his promise to the American people to protect our border. Joining us now is Republican strategist and Iraq War veteran Chris Nyland. Thank you for your time this morning.
Good morning.
Are you surprised at how this has played out so far?
No, I think this is what I would predict. I mean, the president's been consistent about his campaign commitment, and when it comes to government deadlines, this is when policy and budgets really come into play. These are decisions have to be made. Otherwise, government, there starts to become interferences. So I predicted this would happen. I didn't predict that fun press conference in the Oval Office, but it's a new time, isn't it?
It certainly is.
Yes.
You know, the latest word, I guess, from a Democratic strategist is that the White House has come down quite a bit off of $5 billion. And they've countered to the Democrats. The White House has offering $2.1 billion and then $400 million for the president to play with in somewhat of a slush fund. That's a pretty good counter, and that gets a lot closer to their number than they've gotten to his. What do you think happens now?
Well, I think they're trying to negotiate. I mean, Speaker-elect Pelosi said the president wouldn't have the votes in the House. That wasn't true. Obviously, they were able to get through that. And I think that they want to see some sort of action here. This is Congress's responsibility. If it wasn't for the president, we wouldn't be talking about illegal immigration, which has largely become a business in this country in many respects. And it is a security issue. So they're going to have to negotiate. And there needs to be more of a benefactor than just the D.C. bars that do the shutdown drink specials here in Washington.
Let's take a look at this tweet from President Trump, and it reads, quote, "The most important way to stop gangs, drugs, human trafficking, and massive crime is at our southern border. We need border security, and as everyone knows, you can't have border security without a wall. The drones and technology are just bells and whistles. Safety for America." Chris, I mean, over the years, you've heard so many Democrats who are now fighting this say we need border security. That includes Chuck Schumer. I just don't understand the sudden change, the 180 that's been done here.
Well, I mean, I think the Trump train would pick up Chuck Schumer if it was the 2015 Chuck Schumer that wanted all the things that the White House is trying to work on now, not the one that's currently resisting this. I think, you know, one secret people don't really talk about is there are ways for the president to use certain executive funds to shift things around to try to do something. But frankly, it's Congress's job. I'd like to see Congress not get paid when these situations come up. But I think there is some leverage, and the president's trying to kind of work this through. And so, look, they need to come to an agreement, and it's just that simple. I mean, it's Congress's job.
Well, Chris, let's be fair here. I mean, obviously the Democrats have had kind of two positions on immigration. One has said that, you know, securing the border of any kind has been almost immoral. That's been the far left wing. And then the moderates like Schumer and some of the others are saying that they want border security, and they're willing to spend money on it. Maybe not $5 billion on a wall, but they will spend a couple billion, it looks like. What is it about? I mean, you know, we've spent so much money trying to secure that border for so many years, yet they say that a wall doesn't work. What is it that they think will work?
Well, right now they're just playing silly kids games. I mean, look, Speaker-elect Pelosi, Leader Pelosi, essentially said there are equities to be weighed. Whose equities? The American people or all of these foreign constituencies? And remember this, there's Republicans buried in the administration that don't support the president, and Obama appointees that frankly are causing problems and don't want to actually support the president's agenda. He's up against that too. So that's why it's key to continue to implement his agenda when it comes to, for example, veteran entrepreneurs that aren't being paid over at the VA. Those are Obama holdovers that are creating those issues. So the president just needs to stick firm and just continue to negotiate. And the Democrats have the votes. They need to make it happen. It's just that simple.
Chris Nyland, thank you for joining us. We appreciate
it. Good to be with you guys.
Merry Christmas.
Bye.